Good morning, everyone. I hope you are all fit and fine, taking good care of yourself and your families. Yes, great. As you know, I am Miss Himani, and I'm going to teach you English for the time. So are you all ready for the session? Yes? So let's begin the session. First of all, let's look at these important guidelines. Okay, so you should be ready for the lesson with a positive attitude and willingness to learn. You should be seated on chairs with table and not on bed. A notebook and pencil should be handy in case you need to note down something important. No scribbling and sharing of screen is allowed. Do not unmute yourself during the session. An instruction and task given by the teacher should be followed seriously. And if you have any query, any problem, any question during the session, please write them down in the chat box and we'll address them by the end of this session. So, shall we begin the session? Great. Okay. So, let's begin the session with a new word. So, the new word of the day is isolation. We spell it as I-S-O-L-A-T-I-O-N, isolation. Children, you can repeat the word after me. Isolation. Isolation. The meaning of the word is the condition of being separated from other people, towns and countries, etc. So when you have no one around, when you are completely alone, it is called isolation. So the sentence from the new word is isolation from family and friends can lead to feeling of anxiety. Another sentence is when you came in contact with a person who has COVID-19, you have to remain in self-isolation for at least 14 days. Yes, so this is what we are doing these days. We are isolating ourselves from others so that we don't catch the disease. The synonyms of the word are quarantine, solitude, confinement, loneliness, and detachment. So the new word of the day is isolation. It means the condition of being separated from other people. And the synonyms are quarantine, solitude, confinement, loneliness, and detachment. So let's move forward now. So in our last class, we discussed phrasal verbs. Yes, we learned phrasal verbs with stand and go. And we did some tasks on basis of it, on the basis of them. And we also learned some prefix and suffix. Yes, we learn that when we add a particle, it means a part of the word in front of a word, like in the beginning of a word, it is called prefix. And when we add a particle that is a part of a word at the end of the word, it is called suffix. Yes, so let's do some tasks on prefix and suffix. So the first one is, here are some words with prefix and suffix, and you have to separate prefix and suffix from these words to find out the root word. For example, the first word is unkind. So unkind is made by joining two words, which is un plus kind. Un is prefix here and kind is the root word. So the root word for the word unkind is kind. Similarly, the next word is breathless. So can you all tell me what is the root word in breathless? Yes, it is breath. Breath plus less become breathless. So breath is the root word and less is the suffix. The next word is defrost. Again, de prefix and frost root word. Wonderful. Wonder is the root word, full suffix. Quickly. Quick root word, ly suffix. Misunderstand. Miss prefix, understand root word. Harmful. Harm is the root word, full is suffix. So you all get know now how to separate prefix and suffix from the root word, how to identify the root word. Yes? Okay. So the next word is match the words with their correct meaning. In the last session, we learned that the prefix and suffix attach some meaning to the word. For example, the meaning of the word un is not, right? So when we add un before a word, it becomes the opposite of the root word. For example, tie, it means to tie something. Yes, and untie, it means to open something. So the meaning of the word untie is to open. Similarly, helpful. So, full. It means someone who is full of help, who always helps. Beautiful. Again, someone who is full of beauty. Fearless. Fearless. Less means to decrease. Yes. So, without a fear. Homeless. So, without a home. Unroll. It means to lose. Untie means to lose laces, and unroll means to open something. Okay. So, prefix and suffix always add some meaning to the word. Okay. So, now another task for you. You have to add prefix or suffix to the words given in the bracket and fill in the blanks. For example, the first one is, I saw Allison just a moment ago, but now I can't find her. It seems that she appeared. So what can we add before or after appeared to make a new word? Dis. Dis plus appeared becomes disappeared. So the sentence is, I saw Allison just a moment ago, but now I can't find her. It seems that she disappeared. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hear you correctly. I dash you. Understood. So, what new word can we make from the root word understood? Yes, misunderstood. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hear you correctly. I misunderstood you. Our teacher told us not to dash on the field trip. Not to misbehave on the field trip. Miss plus behave becomes misbehave. What a dash day. What a wonderful day. Alex seemed very dash with his family around. Alex seemed very cheerful with his family around. Cheer plus full will become cheerful. My score was low because I made some dash mistake. Care mistake. Careful mistake. No. Careless mistakes. Yes. So, my score was low because I made some careless mistakes. So, children, I hope now prefix and suffix are clear to you. Yes. You can make out the meaning of if I add a prefix or suffix before a word. You can always make out their meanings. And you know how to change a word by adding prefix or suffix now. Great. So now let's move to our next topic, which is unseen passage. So unseen passages are those passages which are never seen or written or read by the student. So as you can see the word unseen, un plus seen, and we just learned that the meaning of the prefix un is not. So something which you have not seen before, called unseen. So a passage which you have not seen, read before is called an unseen passage. So it is completely new to you. So the main object of comprehension is to test one's ability to grasp the meaning of a given passage properly and also one's ability to answer in one's own word the questions based on the passage. So what happens in an unseen passage? First of all, you will be given a passage which you have never seen or read before. You will read the passage carefully and then you have to answer some questions which are based on that passage. Okay, so you can write answers in your own words. You need not jot down the lines from the passage, right? So it is always preferable. It is always, the teacher always wants their children to write in their own words and not to copy down the lines from the passage. Yes, so that it tells us that how much you can understand the meaning. Okay. So the guidelines for attempting an unseen passage are, you first of all, you have to read the passage very carefully. So read the passage carefully. If you don't understand it in one time, you can read it twice, thrice, as many times as you want. But the most important thing is to understand its meaning. Read all the questions carefully and be certain that you understand exactly what is being asked. So the second most important thing is to read the questions very carefully. Okay, so you have to answer, your answer should be based on what is asked in the question. You need not write anything extra or you need not write something which is not being asked in the question. So you have to read them very carefully. Thirdly, Your answer should be based upon the information given in the passage. So your answer should be based on the passage only. Okay, do not write according to your knowledge, according to your understanding of the question. You have to write down on the basis of the information given in the passage. So the last one is, if it is a multiple choice question, always read all the answer choices before selecting the best answers. Okay, so never jump out on the first option which you came across. No. So first of all, you have to read all the options and then choose the best answer. Okay, so you have understood the passage. You have understood it now. Great. So now let's move to the passage. So here is a passage for you. Bob is a frog. He is green with yellow spots. He has a long sticky tongue that he uses to catch flies. He lives near a pond. Sometimes he goes into the water and sometimes he stays on the land. Bob has strong legs that he uses to hop. When Bob was a little baby, he was called a tadpole. So children, now I'm giving you 1 minute. I want you to read this passage on your own. And after that, I'll give you questions on the basis of this passage. And you have to try to answer them on your own. So I'm giving you 1 minute. Quickly go through this passage. Okay, read it very carefully. So let's read it together one more time. Bob is a frog. He is green with yellow spots. He has a long sticky tongue that he uses to catch flies. He lives near a pond. Sometimes he goes into the water and sometimes he stays on the land. Bob has strong legs that he uses to hop. When Bob was a little baby, he was called a tadpole. So you all have read the passage? Yes? So let's move towards the questions. Okay. So these are multiple choice questions. So you have 4 options for every question and you have to choose the best answer now. For example, the first question is, who was Bob? Was he a dinosaur, a giraffe, a frog, or a dog? Bob was a yes. He was a frog. So C is the correct answer. The next is, Bob lives near a lake, pond, river, or sea. So where does Bob live? Does he live near a river, a lake, pond, or sea? Pond. Yes. So B is the correct answer here. Bob has strong dash, tongue, hands, tail, or legs. Yes. D is the correct answer here. He has strong legs, which he uses to hop. So where does Bob live? On tree, in water, and on land? Only in water or only on land? Yes, B is the correct answer. He lives in water as well as on land. So you see, it is so easy to answer these questions. Okay, so now let's move to the question answers. So the first question is, what color was Bob? And one more important thing for children, so whenever we write answers for the unseen passage, you have to write complete sentence. No one word answers are allowed until or unless it is mentioned that you have to give answers in one word. Okay, so you will write in complete sentences. Clear? So the first question is, what color was Bob? Yes, so Bob was green with yellow spots. What sort of tongue does Bob have? Bob has long and sticky tongue. What does Bob use his tongue for? Bob uses his tongue for catching flies. What helps the Bob to hop? His strong legs helps him to hop. What was Bob called when he was little? Bob was called a tadpole when he was little. Yes? So, you see, if you have read the passage very carefully, very attentively, it becomes very easy to attempt unseen passage. Yes? Okay. So, I hope you all have understood unseen passages now. Right? So, you will be able to attempt them. if you have any query, you can write them down in the chat box. Okay, so let's move towards the whole task now. So you remember we have read the story, The Sage's Daughter, in our last few sessions. Okay, so the whole task is related to that story. So we all know that stories are written using a lot of imagination and creativity. Most of the stories you have read have a beginning, middle, and end. And this we have learned in class 3 also, that every story has a beginning, an introduction, characters, settings, a problem, and a solution, right? So what if you can change the ending of the story? We all know in the end, the female mouse who was converted into a young maiden, who was converted into a young baby girl, was again converted into a mouse and was married to a mountain mouse. So I'm giving you a chance and opportunity to change the ending of the story. Okay, so think of a different ending for the story, The Sage's Daughter. So you have to think of a different ending for the story. So think what happened if the girl agreed to marry the Lord of the Wind or the Lord of the Cloud, the Lord of the Mountain. She has so many options. Or you can even bring in some other groom, some other matches for him, right? So this is the whole task for you for the day. So I hope you all have understood everything what we have done today. And if you have any query, any questions, please write them down in the chat box. You can also write your feedback in the chat box. Okay, here is a request for all the parents. We are highly grateful for your genuine cooperation in smooth functioning of online classes. We request you to post your feedbacks on manavps@yahoo.co.in. So I request all the parents to give their feedback on the school email ID, to drop your feedbacks in the school email ID, which is manavps@yahoo.co.in. So children, I hope everything is clear for the day. So it's time to end the session. So take care, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay at home. Thank you so much, everybody.